So I'm starting now. Hello, guys. Good evening, and welcome to another edition of the Marketplace with Uche Onoche. I hope that we were blessed from last week's presentation. I hope that by now you'll be able to say no. You should be able to say no. But before I proceed, I just want to say, try and as much as possible to keep safe. Try as much as possible to know how you walk and the places. I know that the protest is dying down, but please, we need you safe. We need you alive, whole and hearty. Watch how you move. And I know that the Almighty God will protect you as you go. Okay, it's a wet evening. I don't know if it's raining where you are. Where I am, it's raining cats and dogs. And I know if you don't have electricity at home, if you have a NEPA problem, I'm sure that today you will sleep well. Okay? Sometimes those generators can be noisy. Maybe you don't even need to put it on and just sleep. Okay. All right. Today we're talking about the entrepreneurial spirit. What is entrepreneurial spirit? Before we go to the focus of what we are talking today, I have a direction that I want to take us today. Okay, so let's just look at what entrepreneurial spirit is. Entrepreneurial spirit is a mindset. It's a mindset. It's not something physical. It's more like intangible. Something is a mindset. It's what you are thinking about, and so it's an attitude and a certain approach to thinking. Entrepreneurship is an attitude, first of all, a certain approach to thinking that actively seeks out to change rather than waiting to adapt to change. So what do I mean here? I'm talking about it is an attitude, a certain approach to thinking, a certain kind of thinking that says, look, there has to be change. A thinking that says, look, why do we have to climb this flight of stairs every day? Can't we get something that will lift us up? Can't we get something that will make it easier for us to climb this 10-story, 20-story building? What is something? Is that attitude that wants to challenge the status quo? That attitude that wants to bring a change. Entrepreneurial spirit is a mindset that embraces critical questioning. For you to be an entrepreneur, someone with a great entrepreneurial spirit is able to critically question things. Question things the way they are. Can't we do something better? Is there no better way of doing this? I know that we have celebrated whoever invented this product. But can't we do it better now? We're in the 21st century. Maybe it's not serving as effectively as it used to serve in the 20th century. So an entrepreneurial mindset is that mindset that we question the status quo. Maybe we need something better. And that's where innovation comes. That's an innovative mind that questions what is already existing. Because the things that you see in existence today is because somebody questioned what used to be and now what is has come. So now is to question what is. So what could be will come. So it is now about what could be, not what is currently, what we're seeing currently. And that is innovation. is a mindset that critically questions the services. How have we been offering services to our clients? Are we pampering our clients enough? Perhaps now we need to look at better ways to serve our client so that we can increase our clientele, so that we can have more clients, we can have more satisfied clients. You know, so these are some of the things that entrepreneurial spirit, someone that has entrepreneurial spirit, this is how they think. Continuous improvement of our services. If someone with entrepreneurial spirit is never satisfied with what they have done, even though you call them accomplished, even though you call them successful, they are never satisfied. They feel that there is more out there. We are making 100 million today. And someone with entrepreneurial spirit will say, why can't we make 500 million? And when you begin to make 500 million, why can't you say, why can't you make a billion? Okay, we are making 1 billion naira. Why can't you say, let's now make $1 billion? Entrepreneurship spirit is that spirit that questions what you're already doing. Is entrepreneurship spirit is about seeing the big picture and thinking like an owner. Entrepreneurial spirit is the spirit that sets targets that might look unreasonable to normal people. But entrepreneurial spirit is someone that says, I can do it, not for the love of money, for the task itself, the ability to be able to stretch ourselves, to be able to get to that point. It's not about the money, it's about the services and the products and the innovation that goes with our product and services that will make us earn that much. So the target is get this amount, but you need to do the things that will help you to achieve it. That is the entrepreneurial spirit. Okay, so, but my focus really is not about the entrepreneurial spirit tonight. My focus is, are you cut out to be an entrepreneur? That's my focus, because all of us cannot be entrepreneurs. You cannot, they are highly successful career people. They are highly successful number two executive directors, general managers in some companies are wealthier than the managing director. You don't have to own a company for you to be successful. You don't. You can work for someone, retire at 65, and be a multimillionaire. You don't have to run that company. You don't have to own a company. Not because you are in between job, all of a sudden, I need to become a business person. No, it doesn't work that way. All of us are not called into business. We are not all called to become entrepreneurs and business people. Some people are career people. Some people are career people. That is who they are. Some people are government people. Some people are politicians. Some people are soldiers. Some people are policemen. Some people, that is what they are. And you can't take it away from them. But does it mean that they will not be successful or rich? No. So this presentation, because a lot of people keep asking me, oh, how do I know that I'm a call to be an entrepreneur, this, that. So I now said, okay, since I have had many questions about this, now is the time for me to now let us look at, are you really cut out to be a business person? I want to help you tonight. I want to help you tonight to know if you are really cut out to be a business person. Why? It's very important, because look at these statistics. If you have been running your business for the past 5 years, know that you have achieved what 80% of startup founders in Nigeria couldn't do. If you have run your SME, your business, for 5 years in Nigeria, 80% of people that started with you were not that successful. A study shows that only one out of 25 businesses that start together survive after 10 years. And we've heard that 80% of businesses in Nigeria fail in the first 5 years. and 96% of those businesses fail in 10 years. So it means that it's only 4% of the businesses that start every year, that start every 10 years, become successful. There's not another statistics after 10 years, those that we fold. So within that 4 years also, 4%, after 10 years, within 15 years, 2% of that 4% will fall by the wayside. And so we must critically know, are we cut out for this? You don't need to leave that lucrative job and say, look, I'm tired of calling someone, sir. Look, if you are a business person, you will call your client, sir. You cannot go outside calling someone, sir. You must call somebody, sir. Your clients are your boss, your bosses. Whoever gives you money is your boss. Whether you are the MD, CEO, or chairman, you are humble to anybody that is giving you money. Anybody that is giving you money for the product or service, you smile at them. So it's not about, I want to do my own thing. I'm tired of running another person's vision. I want to run my own vision. It's not about that. Are you able, do you have what it takes? And you don't need to be ashamed if you are not called to be an entrepreneur. You don't need to be ashamed at all, so that you will not swell the statistics that we're seeing today. You don't have to swell the statistics. You can do better. So you have to be mindful of that. You know, so with these statistics, every aspiring entrepreneur and business person should be very nervous to know what they are going into. Just because you can start a business, just because you can take loan, just because you have some retirement benefit, you want to do business when you know that you are not cut out for it. Before you take that leap of faith, because a lot of people say, I have faith that I will make. It's not about faith. You have faith. Do you have skills? What are your skill sets to be able to run a business? Not because you are a good engineer means that you'll be able to run a good engineering firm. No, sir. Running a business is different from being a professional. You can be the best IT person, but you don't know how to run an IT business, because they're two different things. So let me offer you some clues, some tips, some direction for you to discover if you are really cut out to be an entrepreneur, a business person, before you launch out. I don't want you to launch out and when you get in there, you begin to be discouraged. So let us discuss it. Okay, so let's look at some of the tips that will make you realize if you're an entrepreneur or not. Can you stand the heat? They say if you cannot stand the heat in the kitchen, you get out. If you can't stand the heat, if being in the kitchen looks as if you are being put in an oven, then you know that being in the kitchen or being a chef is not for you. Before you jump into business, you need to be comfortable with being uncomfortable. Because business will make you uncomfortable. Every day you need to be trying something new. And you know what? Growth happens at the edge of your comfort zone. So if you're willing to go there, if you're willing to go beyond that comfort zone, if you're willing to leave your comfort zone, you may not be cut out to be an entrepreneur. Because let me tell you, there is so much every day as an entrepreneur. This is how I can explain being an entrepreneur to you. I was watching a professional lawn tennis player, doing his practice. And he has three or four machines from three different angles. And those machines are shooting balls at him at very high speed. And he has to hit each one at a particular spot. So you can imagine having balls. Balls are coming from here. Balls are coming from here, and you are shooting those balls and you are hitting them, and your coach is telling you must hit it at a particular spot. That is a professional. So if you are not able to juggle all those balls, please, long tennis is not for you. If you want, look, coach, let me deal with this angle first. Then when I finish this angle, I deal with this angle. You cannot be a professional. The same way with being a business person. As soon as you sit on your table, your staff will come with one issue. As soon as, before you handle your staff issue, a local government issue will come. Before you finish that, they just hit your car. Before you finish that, police is arresting your goods. Before you finish this, your key staff is sick. Before you finish, you are having issue every day. Before you finish that, there's one client that is not happy with you. Before you are dealing with one client, this other client is shouting, why are you ignoring my call? You are not replying my text message. That is the life of an entrepreneur. So if you don't have energy for it, please go and work for somebody. Because business is about handling solutions, handling problems. That's why I tell you, it is not about being a professional. It's about being able to handle those things that business, running a business throws at you. Running a business throws things at you that you will not imagine. And for you to be a seasoned business person, you have to go around. You have to go around the learning curve of doing business. These things hit you every day. And apart from that, what gives every CEO nightmare is end of the month. Whether your people work, they didn't work. Whether they brought in money, they facilitated, they assisted, or they did not, you will pay them salary. Except you want to let them go. From the third week of every month, every CEO is sweating because he knows that time of the month has come again. So if you can't handle that and say, look, there's no money now, so I can't pay myself. They should wait. You have some CEOs that are owing salary 6 months, 1 year. Then after 12 months, they will pay you 2 months. You are not cut out to be a business person. You are really not cut out. When you tell me, I know people that do that, they say there's no money. You are not cut out to be a business person. You're not cut out to handle an organization because you are handling an organization based on emotions, based on what is happening. Before your people can take a bullet for you, they need to know that you care. When you're owing someone for 6-12 months, what input do you think he's making? What input do you think he's putting there? So if you say, no, I can't kill myself, I can't do, you must be mindful of these things before you open shop for business. These are the things that make you a seasoned entrepreneur. These are the things that make you a seasoned businessman. So if you can't stand that heat, please go and work for somebody that can take the heat. Number two, you are in it for quick cash. I know that profit is the result of successful business. It shouldn't be the reason why you are in business. I tell people, a lot of young people, you start business to solve a problem and to serve others. You are not in business to make quick money. Because the turnaround time, it takes time for you to build. Before people start giving you their money, they must trust you. They must trust your product. They must trust your services. They must trust you as a person. And once you get clients to trust you, it's easy for them to give you money and give you money on a constant basis. See, let me tell you, God in his infinite wisdom has put discerning spirit in every man. And some people have more of it than others. What do I mean? Have you ever been in a situation that you see somebody trying to sell something to you? And the person at the end of the day will ask you, why didn't you buy? Say, that man's mouth is too sweet. It looks as if there's something about him. What does that tell you? It tells you that man was projecting money better than customer services. That person is projecting the money he's going to make better than projecting the business or the services he's offering. So what does that mean? It means that when you place, please, your handwork is better. Your handwork is more important than your bank account, what is in your bank account. And I will explain it in this way. God wanted people to believe him. God exalted his word above his name. Do you know why God did it? Why he exalted his name above his word above his name? So that you will believe him for what he says. He is a God of integrity. So when he gives you his word, take it to the bank. He's more interested in his word. So also should you be more interested in your hard work. The things that you do are very important, more important to you than the cash that is in your bank account. Guess what? When people know you for excellence, they know you for diligence. You know what will happen? That bank account will be filling up so fast that you will not even keep record. You can't keep record of what is in that bank account. Because you are more interested in offering a good service than you are more interested in getting cash from people. You see some people, when you see them, the mere look in your eyes. Don't you know that from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks? Have you heard of that thing before? From the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So from the abundance of, let me job this man. See, Mugu is coming. You don't know that the person you are calling Mugu, that you're calling fool, that you are the one that is exposing yourself. Because everything that you are saying, you think that you are smart. You think that you know what you are saying. You want to job him. But all you are saying is that you are making the person know that all you are interested in is in money. Because from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. You can't control it. And as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. So all of us think that you as a person, Uchonoche is a brand. And the way I am coming to you today, I'm coming to you exhibiting that brand. So as I think in my mind, that's how I am. So when you see someone that is thinking profit, is thinking money, thinking how to dupe his clients, it will show, my brothers and sisters. It will show. Don't think that you can outsmart people. You can outsmart people sometime, but you cannot outsmart them all the time. You are in business to solve problems for people, and people will reward you for that. You are in business to bring ideas, that workable ideas that will serve your society and your community, and they will reward you for money. Anything less than that, if you put money before the work, you will be miserable. That's why many people fail in their business, because they are looking at it from the wrong angle. And once you start from the profit side, I'm not saying you won't make profit, but anybody that looks, seeth thou a man diligent in his ways, he will stand before kings. It's your excellence, the excellence of your work, that will make you stand before kings and queens and rich men that will buy that your... You can swindle people for 1,000 naira. No, say 100,000 naira. But if you are diligent, that thing that you are selling 100,000, someone can buy it 5 million... That same thing, people that value it, people that understand it, can buy it. So it's not about cash, it's about work. Okay, let me move on. Lack of patience and perseverance. If you don't have these two, please do not bother to be an entrepreneur. Starting a business is not about the next big thing. It's not about what is trending. It's not about what is shining. It's not about, I saw it on Facebook, this thing is happening. Let us buy this thing from China and supply it here. It's not about that. It's about picking a dream, an idea, staying on that dream, going through all the learning curves, even when times get tough, even when the going gets tough, you stay on it. Because look, let me tell you, everything that you start, there's a way, I don't know why it happens this way, that when you start something, the first time you start something, after a while, After a while that you start something, when you start something in the beginning, things are moving, they're moving. But after a while, the things start to go down. At that point, we know who has that entrepreneurial spirit. Stay on it. Just because it's no longer profitable as it used to be, does not mean you should abandon it. You are just getting to another level to understand what it takes. So being an entrepreneur requires unwavering laser focus, sharp focus. If you don't have patience or are unwilling to push through tough times, launching a business might not be for you. If you don't have patience, perseverance to go through tough times and say that I will succeed, I have faith that this thing will work, business is not for you. Let me tell you, business can give you high blood pressure if you don't have that resilience to go through the things that you will meet on the way. Patience and unwillingness to move on. If you can't do that, then business is not for you. If you have stage fright, if you are shy, then business might not be for you. Why? As an entrepreneur, as a business person, you must wear many hats. And being a spokesperson is one of them. Being the voice of your business is one of them. Being the PRO is one of them. Being the public relations officer is one of them. So if you shy away from public speaking, you might not be able to effectively push the vision. Because let me tell you, you might have a staff, you might have a partner that can speak very well, but the partner doesn't know the vision because the core of the vision is within you. The partners might not really know the vision. They might not be able to interpret the vision just like you. So what it means that you must be the spokesperson. If you cannot, if you are shy at public speaking, you can learn. You can go to groups. There are many groups you can belong that can help you to be able to come out of it. If not, if you have money, then you can hire a spokesperson. But mind you, the spokesperson might not be the originator of the idea. So there's something, there's a passion. There's passion that is inside. You will hear passion from the person that started the business. You will hear passion from the person that has the idea. That passion will be strong and stronger in someone that is just speaking on behalf of the person that started it. The difference is clear. So you must try as much as possible to be the spokesperson. And guess what? Opportunities don't always come as scheduled. They don't come in a scheduled manner. So you might not know when you can meet that opportunity. So because you don't know where you can meet that opportunity, you must be the front man of the company from time to time. You can go to a birthday party, opportunity comes there. And what if the person you hire as postman is not with you because he doesn't work weekend? You can be in church and opportunity comes. Your spokesman might not go to the same church with you. You can be traveling. You can be traveling to your village. You can be traveling to your city and opportunity comes. Are you going to wait for your spokesman to come? No, you must be the spokesperson. Stage fright, please, except you are not hungry. You tell me you are shy, it's because you are not hungry yet. When that hunger pangs come on you, you'll be able to speak. If you're uncomfortable with promoting yourself and promoting your business, then it becomes problematic. Maybe you are not cut out. Not maybe, you are not cut out to be an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur must be able to have the 5 minutes rule. I have a book called Secrets of Divine Selection. There's 5 minutes rule. And in that 5 minutes rule, what will you tell someone, a vision helper, a customer, a high net worth customer and influencer, what will you tell them in 5 minutes? You must be prepared. You must prepare your line that anywhere you meet them, you'll be able to speak. So if you can't do that, maybe entrepreneurship is not for you. Number five, you hate roller coaster rides. What do I mean by that? When you are an entrepreneur, there is no flat surface. The graph is not linear graph at all. One day you may be checking up a steep hill. The next time you might be going on a gut-wrenching free fall down a slope. Today you will be going on mountain top. You're on top of the mountain. Tomorrow you might be falling from that mountain. That's how entrepreneurship is. You might have it good for 1 year. Then you might go through hell for the next 2 years. So you must be prepared to hang in and enjoy the ride. Let me tell you, enjoy the ride. You cannot come and go and kill yourself because you started business. As Nigerians say, you cannot come and go and kill yourself. But it doesn't mean that you abandon it. You need to know, realize that in life, there's no flat surface. There's no linear graph. Life is up and down, up and down. You are up today, you are enjoying. Tomorrow, you come down. Doesn't mean that you start confessing negatively and start saying that this business is not working. You can make it work. Entrepreneurship, in summary, is not for people that have weak stomach, that only rejoice when something is good, and they don't rejoice when something goes bad. No, entrepreneurship is not for you if you cannot stomach this thing. All right, number six, if you are okay with complexities. You know, some people are complex by nature, and they carry that complex nature into their business. Winston Churchill says, complexity is not a virtue at all. Simple, straightforward businesses are often very successful. You see some business owners say, no, there's some trade secrets we need to hide. There's some things we need to cover. We can't do this. We can't do that. Let us cover this thing. Let us do this in this way. Let us do that so that people will not just come and see what we are doing. No, some people hide things from their own staff. How do you expect the staff to be efficient when it doesn't have some information? If your product or service is complicated, it will be hard to communicate that to your customers and your employees. Try not to run a complex organization. Please, try not to run a complex organization. Let your organization be free, be simple, and straightforward. You know why? A confused mind will always say no. A confused client will always say no. When clients don't understand things, they will say no. So please, try as much as possible to make sure your organization is not complex. If you know that you have difficulty in divulging information, carrying people along, then if you are secretive in terms of hiding certain things, then maybe you are not called to be an entrepreneur. Go and work for someone. Number seven, if you have lack resilience and stamina, launching a business is like running a marathon. At the start, your adrenaline kicks in when you are running a marathon. But 15 miles down the line, 20 miles down the line, what happens? It begins to tell on your body. Your legs begin to feel very heavy because you have reached where? You have reached what is called the middle mile. It's called the middle mile. So business people that are willing to push through that portion of the journey called the middle mile, the place where challenges and drudgery happens, that is the place where people feel weak. That is the place where people begin to, the workload begins to get heavy. The workload begins to get heavy. People begin to, you know, you need to put in more time. You know, a business is not moving that smooth. You have to put in more to get the same effect that you're, to get the same results you were having before. At that point, those that can continue are those that will be successful, the resilient and the people that have stamina. Because when you are at the middle mile, what happens? Your body begins to hurt. You begin to breathe your breathing becomes labor. That is where you are overwhelmed. You are like that tennis ball, like that tennis player, that balls are coming at you from every angle. We are all human beings. You will become labored. You can become overwhelmed. But despite these inconveniences, you must place one foot in front of the other and keep pressing on. Entrepreneurs are the ones that will put one foot in front of the other and keep moving. If you lack stamina, you will burn out easily from this overwhelming load that will come upon you. But if you are resilient and not say, look, I think maybe I should go and look for a job. Maybe I should try something else. When you go that way, you are not cut out to be a business person. If you know that you cannot stand this heat in the kitchen, go and work for somebody else. There is dignity in labor. There is dignity in working for someone else. We don't all have to be business people. You see a successful business person, you don't know the high blood pressure he's suffering from. You don't know what he suffers every day. You are just looking at the fancy car, the fancy office, the fancy home. You don't know what they go through every day. You might not be able to have that, to stomach the things they stomach. Know that it's not easy. The business terrain is tough, especially in Nigeria. The business terrain is very tough. There are many things that are dragging you down. Taxes, government, local government, the community, theft, vandalization, this, that, many things that are pulling you down. Ease of this doing business is not there like that in Nigeria. Policies bring you down. So if these things can weigh you down, then you are not cut out to be a business person. Perhaps you should try something else. Number 8, if you don't believe in marketing. Some people don't believe in marketing. Then perhaps you are not cut out to be a business person. Why? No matter what the economy looks like, you must keep on marketing. Thank God for social media now. You pay less to take your product and services out there. It does not mean that you will forget traditional marketing. It doesn't mean that you forget one-on-one knocking on doors. I say combine all of them. Combine all of them to receive that success. Marketing makes the business world go round. When the economy declines, it's time for you to double your effort in marketing. You know why? Because competitors are pulling back too. So those that market more, you will steal your competitors, or you will take some of your competitors' market, some of their clients, some of their customers, if you do not relent on marketing, even when the economy declines. So you must be willing to continue to throw revenue at marketing no matter what. It's a risk that you must take. I canceled a man, a business person one time. I said, look, put 2 million or put 5 million in this time. He said, we're not making money. How can I put that kind of money? How can I vote that kind of money for marketing and advertisement? How can I do that when the business, I say, look, put that thing there. You will not regret it. Some people, once the economy begins to go down, they cut off things and they don't know the ones that are relevant to the business. Don't cut off marketing. When things are going down, market more. When things are going down, advertise more. And you have social media to slash almost 60% of your marketing costs off, because they can help you with just small data. So marketing is very effective. If you know that you don't have heart to take 5 million and put in marketing, take me 2 million, put in marketing. You don't have that heart to vote those kind of things, especially when you don't see direct response, direct result from it. Then you know that you might not be able to be a business person. You're not cut out for it, because business people take risk. Business is risk. The more risk, the more profit. Okay. All right. Inability. Number 9, inability to develop workable business systems. Running a business is complicated. Entrepreneurs need to be able to delegate and direct others on what to do. This means you need the ability to take a task, break it down into easy, actionable steps for implementation. So it takes a CEO, a business person that has the skill to produce, develop workable business systems that can run whether he's there or not. So if you cannot trust your staff, some people don't delegate at all. They micromanage everything. They want to do everything. So because of that, they are not moving as fast as they should. They are not moving at a very fast pace. So what it means is that you have not been able to break down the day-to-day tasks, the day-to-day things that people need to do into easy and actionable steps for implementation. And if you are not able to do that, you will not be able to get the best out of your staff, because they will not be able, they have nothing. They have no actionable steps to implement. You know, big ideas are a dime a dozen. Knowing how to implement those ideas is the game changer. You have ideas, you must be able to put it in such a way that people can run with it. What is your vision for the company? Make it plain so that those that read it can run with it. Those that come into your company can look at the vision statement and the mission statement and run with it. Make the task, put it in such a way that people can understand it and run with it. If you cannot do that effectively, then you might not be cut out to be an entrepreneur. I know some people that will just go and get a consultant. People like me, to give them actionable steps. We will come and we'll give you those actionable steps, but we will not implement it for you. So you as a CEO should be able to understand it and be able to cascade it down to your employees and to your partners. And this is the way forward. This is what it is. And you should be able to supervise the implementation, to be able to supervise them. If you can't do that, you know, I told the man that told me he was struggling with his business. I told him, he doesn't have this type of energy. That why does he have a manager? And why does, I say, look, a CEO supervises. Anything that is not supervised cannot be implemented. Any work that is not supervised is no work at all. You must be able to know every aspect of your business. You must be able to know the steps to take in every aspect of your business. Once you do that, you will see that people run with the ideas. They run with each step without you being there. So you can actually take a vacation for 3 months and come back, your business has not folded up. True businessmen should be able to go on vacation 3 months, some 6 months, come back and the business is still running, because people know their place and know the tasks they need to do. And it just requires minimum supervision to be able to do that. So if you can't do that effectively, perhaps you're not cut out to be a business person. Number 10, when you often shy away from problems, they bring one problem to you. I cannot kill myself. This is my staff. They want to kill me. They bring something from government. You say, this government said, I don't understand this government. They are not helping anybody. And this one happens. I don't have money. Maybe the roof is leaking. You say, I don't have money. That thing should wait. Everything bothers you. Every problem that comes, you just pack it to one side. I don't have energy for this one, please. Then you are not cut out to be an entrepreneur. As an entrepreneur, the buck stops with you. You must be willing to upset the apple cart at any point in time and make tough decisions. Sometimes your clients might not be happy with your decision, but you yourself, you have to be comfortable with your own decision. Every business person should be comfortable with his own decision. Don't be uncomfortable. Don't be shaking because a client even though the client is paying you top dollar or top naira, and you'll be shaking. Because sometimes these clients can make you do things that are not in the best interest of your company. So even your customers are not happy with you, and you've got to be comfortable with in your own skin. As long as you know that thing that you're doing is in the best interest of your own company. You cannot shy away from problems. You must confront them. When a client is calling you, pick the call and manage that client. Tell him something, pacify him. Sorry, sir, we will walk it. Sorry does a whole lot of magic. Sorry, sir, we will meet up. We will go to the client, explain to them, show that you are considerate. You show that you know that they are not happy and you are showing concern. Show them concern. Don't shy away from that. There are some business people, when the client is upset, they will hide. They will travel and say, sir, I'm in the village. My mother is not well. Just all to just evade the issues. Tomorrow, your customer will not be, they will not see you as somebody that is dependable. You must face every challenge squarely and do it to the best and respond to them to the best of your ability. You must be able to resolve problems effectively and promptly and on time. You know why? See, it's not big problems that take out companies. It's small issues that are neglected that will wreck companies, because it's small issues overlooked that become big and become like a stronghold in the neck of the organization that will cause the organization to die. Handle issues, especially when they are small. Staff conflict, employee conflict. Don't say this, two of you, you people are mature. Why are you people behaving like children? Don't do that. No matter what it is, resolve those two staff, because if they feel disgruntled in any way, it's your company that will suffer. If it looks as if you are favoring someone over the other, it's your company that will suffer. Learn at any point in time, learn to be able to resolve issues no matter what those issues are. Learn to resolve them, you know, so that they will not grow bigger. Okay. All right. So in summary, entrepreneurial spirit is what? It's a state of mind that goes beyond just creating a business. It is a state of mind that will push an individual to find courage to use his resources, his full potential, implement all the necessary means to carry out the business he wants. It's a state of mind that will influence the way it will act and the quality of the result that will result in eventually. So in summary, this entrepreneurial spirit is the I can do spirit. No matter where it is, no matter where you find yourself, no matter what you are feeling, you say, I will get through this. There's always an idea. There's always a solution to every problem. If you stay hang on to that problem long enough, you will get a solution to it. You will receive a solution no matter what it is. Hang on to it. Don't abandon that business. Someone listen to me. Don't abandon that business today because you feel that you come to the middle mile. The middle mile is just testing you. If you can overcome that middle mile, you have entered into another higher level of profit. So learn to overcome. That middle mile is just to test to your resilience, to test you, to test your stamina. If you can overcome it, there's nothing that is stopping you. Okay, thank you for listening today. But before I go, I just want to tell you, I have books, I have materials that are beneficial to you. I've spoken for like 50 minutes now, but some of these things I speak, the audio, they are there. We have ebooks there. Some of my books are there. Some of my videos are there. Some of my courses, some of this presentation. Like, if you want this presentation after now, you can have it at next to nothing. Just visit uchonoche.com/shop. uchonoche.com/shop. You will get most of these materials there at highly discounted rates. I want you to be able to go there to this website and please pick up something. There's something that will be beneficial to you. Also, I want to talk about a close group of people. I'm looking for 500 people that I want to close, a close group that I speak to them every day. I speak about topics that will help. I groom them. These are the princes that are coming out of Africa. Marketplace Apostle is committed to raising princes out of Africa. Princes in the marketplace, princes in leadership, career, and business. So I have people that I want to mentor. I'm looking at 500 of them. They are increasing by day. If you look at the slide before me, or check my DM after now, you will see the link. The link is linktr.ee/Uche Onoche. Look at that close group. It will, once you register, it will lead you to our WhatsApp group or our Telegram group, whichever you prefer. But the WhatsApp, we can communicate on WhatsApp than on the Telegram where you get a broadcast. But if anyone suits you, or you can have both. Please visit linktr.ee/Uche Onoche and register. I want you to mentor me in this period. It's not open for it's not open forever. I'm going to close it once I get the number that I want. The number is filling out every day. And help me do something. Send this link to somebody that you know that needs grooming in the area of business, career, leadership, personal finance, marriage, and whatever it is, life coaching. Apart from being a business and leadership coach, I'm also a life coach, and I can help in that area. Okay, before I leave, let me talk about one more thing. I have a Wednesday live with Uche Onoche. It's called What's on Your Mind. Every Wednesday by 4 p.m., what do? I answer questions. Like now, I've taken a topic to teach today. But on Wednesday, I am not taking any topic. The topic is your question. Ask any question. If you know someone that needs a question, a direct answer to a question, send them to hook up with Uche Onoche Live on Wednesday, Uche Onoche Wednesday Live. Ask your question. I'll come on live by 4 p.m. and I will answer your question directly. So that it's not about topic, it's about answering that your question. So if you know someone that is interested, or you know someone that this will benefit, please forward that link. Also, follow me on uchonoche.com on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. You can also follow me on Marketplace Apostle in these handles. I want to introduce to you Make in Nigeria. I am also the convener of Make in Nigeria, the largest gathering of business people in the South and Southeast region of our nation. And I want you to be part of this year's Make in Nigeria. It is virtual. It is starting it will run from the 12th to 14th November. You can also follow us on my handle, on Marketplace Apostle handle, or Make in Nigeria has its own handles. So you can also follow us there, makeinnigeria.com. There's also a community there. You get all the information that you want, or you can get it on Facebook and Instagram. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram to get it live. They are wonderful speakers. We're already advertising those speakers. Hook up on this, and I'm sure that this year is going to be something else. Apart from the keynote sessions, there are panel sessions that will be dealing with issues, direct issues that affect you as a business person, as a career person, as someone in leadership. Don't miss this year. It's virtual, and it's 2 hours per session. There's morning and evening. Hook up to it, and I'm sure that your life will be blessed. I look forward to seeing you on Wednesday. I look forward also. Just help me share this. Someone help me share this. Share it to someone to be part of Wednesday Live. Also, this presentation now, you can also share it, or you can go to uchonoche.com and you can get this presentation from it. So have a good night. I know it's a wet night. Let's sleep early so that we can get home on time. God bless you guys. I see you on Wednesday. Take care. Please be safe. Watch how you move. And because we need you, our nation needs you, your family needs you, and may God preserve you in this time and in this season. God bless you all. Good night. Talk to you. Talk to you.